when this thing does turn around, you're going to have a ton, and I mean a ton of sellers that come out the woodworks that want to list their property. Once they realize we're at the top and it's kind of leveled off. Like, how else do you handle like the ups and downs and the frustrations and the disappointments? There's no other way to handle them except for to just keep moving forward. You can't go backwards. I mean, backwards is quitting. So there's only one way to handle them, and that's just to move forward, you know? And here's the thing. Every single person is going to hit those moments. All right, every single person. So if you look at the top producer in your area, you need to look at him and think, you know, he went through what I'm going through right now and probably even worse. Because think about it, whoever the top producer is right now, chances are he didn't become the top producer overnight. And he didn't have a lot of the advantages that you have technology-wise. I know I didn't have any of these advantages. Hell, man, I don't even want to tell you what I had to go through to get where I am. You guys have it made to the nth degree, you know, and you're talking about how do you handle toxic situations. You know, I don't know. I don't know. You know, dial 100 people in 3 minutes flat and do what took Ricky 8 hours, really 15 hours to do in a matter of an hour and a half. You know what I'm saying? You can compress your time and what you, and your productivity can be compressed into 10 times faster than what it took me. I get this question, like, what would you tell your 20-year-old self? And the answer is nothing, because the way that everything played out, right, was absolutely perfect up to this point, right? Because if I wouldn't have lost everything and went through what I had to learn through that moment, then I wouldn't have appreciated it enough to build the foundation that I built after that, right? And I wouldn't be where I am now because I wouldn't appreciate success enough to not take it for granted enough to actually build a real business, right? That, see, when you build your business the way that I'm teaching you guys to build your business, it doesn't matter if a market crashes or if it explodes, or it doesn't matter if people don't want to use you as an agent, or if your buyer goes ghost on you. It doesn't matter if you screw up your social media or make some people mad at you, or you know, sound dumb or make a mistake that costs somebody 10 grand, you can just pay it. None of that matters. So if I could go back, right, I really wouldn't tell myself anything. I'd be scared to tell myself anything, because if I didn't go through what I went through, I don't know that I would be where I am right now, or I don't know that I would be pushing as hard as I push at this point. There's so many things swirling around in my head. Next year, okay, 2022, I feel like my only responsibilities career-wise are going to be creating great content, continuing to spread my message, traveling and speaking, and taking care of my family. Like, I literally think that's going to be my life next year. It's just social media and speaking. And if you notice, I didn't say sales in there because I honestly don't think I'll be in sales. I mean, I'll be honest with you. I don't think I'll be in sales. Like, I told you guys before the end of last year that my goal this year was to do 70 deals, right? So I've done 100 deals a year. Every year since 2014. And this year, my goal is to do 70. Why? That's actually a challenge for me because I have so much business just falling in my lap from the brand that I created, that to do 70, I'll literally have to turn business down. And for me to do that is the hardest thing in the world to do. But the thing is the reason why I want to give myself that challenge is because all my other businesses are really adding up to be like monstrous. It's like a monstrous situation. I thought my real estate business was monstrous. And you know, by this time next, by the end of the year, those up my other businesses will like, you know, my real estate business will be literally like, well, the other businesses will overshadow my real estate business so much that I'm really not going to have a choice at that point, you know? And then I'm going to have to go, okay, where's full value at here, right? Where, how can I give the world the most value? Because that's what it's going to boil down to. And the value that I bring agents through my social medias and coaching calls and speeches is really where I bring the world the most value. And so that, I think that's really kind of where I'm going to land over the next 12 months. They get really excited. They're in this great new business. Sky's the limit. Get excited. Couple weeks go by. They get frustrated because they can't learn everything in a day. They see this mountain of knowledge they have to learn. Then they become disappointed, right? Because they didn't sell anything in 2 months. So like they're excited and then boom, they crash with disappointment and frustration. It happens every time, right? Even the ones that do get a quick sell, then they have a false insecurity in the business. and then they start, then they think that's how the business is done. You can get a deal that quick, and then they don't get a deal for like 6 months, you know, and they're like, wow, you know, this, you know, here's my frustration. And you're going to hit those peaks and valleys of the emotional roller coaster, and just realize it's completely normal, right? So just chalk up the first year to, if I get 5-10 deals, that's amazing. Because at the end of the day, a first year agent, they just look at the bottom line. They look at transactions. They're like, okay, I did this many transactions. You know, that's my win or loss. You know, here's what I made in commissions. But there's this whole other world, right? You learn how to write a contract worth $1 million to you. You learn how to use MLS worth $1 million to you. You learn how to talk, and you added a few people to your database worth millions of dollars to you. You literally made millions of dollars that first year through the knowledge that you gained. And nobody's even talking about that part of it. They're just saying, I've sold 5 properties. And it's like, dude, 5 properties is incredible, along with the millions of dollars worth of knowledge that you acquired. You know what I mean? When this thing does turn around, you're going to have a ton, and I mean a ton of sellers that come out the woodworks that want to list their property. Once they realize we're at the top and it's kind of leveled off, you know, because that's why they're not selling, because they're like, it's just going to keep going. Why would I sell? It's going up. You know, right. But once they get the idea that things are starting to level off and it's not really going up anymore, we're going to see the market get flooded with people trying to make sure that they get that highest price before it starts coming down a little bit.
In regards to that, with market trends and kind of the market being crazy right now, naturally, you've been an agent for a while. So like you mentioned earlier, you didn't really get to start off with all the fancy technology and dialers and all these systems. For someone who's newer, or maybe, you know, there's agents who are in the works of becoming an agent right now, studying for their tests perhaps, what do you think is worth our time and worth actually putting money toward? Or what do you think, you know, are things we should stay away from? Or do you have any opinions on that?
I honestly think this, man. I honestly think that you, like, if you're a full-time agent and even a part-time agent, you can take this and kind of rearrange it around your schedule, right? But I think if you're a full-time agent, I think you should be looking at 8 o'clock, answer emails, organize business, schedule your day. 8:30, figure out who we're calling. From 9 to 12, we're just making calls. We're just making calls. Listen, guys, that is technology. That is finding phone numbers in a snap of a finger. That is hitting a button and auto-dialing numbers, just ta-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, like an AK-57. I didn't have this when I was coming up. You know, you're going to get some internet leads, you know, from somewhere, right? And you're going to want to incorporate those into your calling sessions from 9 to 12. Or like Monday, you might do all internet leads that you picked up over the weekend. Tuesday, we're doing old expireds. Wednesday, we're doing circle prospecting. Friday, we're following up. I don't know. You guys got to figure out the formula that works best for you on how you're going to structure and who you're going to call. All I can tell you is if you spend half your time on the phone and half your time on marketing and social media and stuff like that, you will be the most dangerous agent out there, right? Because when you combine the fact that you understand that voice to voice is the common denominator, real conversation is the common denominator for all closings. When you realize that, when you realize business is unlimited forever, and that you can't talk to every single person in your market, and you really combine the fact that you're young and great at social media, when you combine the fact of voice to voice and digital marketing, that's when you become the most dangerous agent out there. And then when you put all that on the back of building relationships over transactions and building your database on the front end of a weekly email, it's over. It's over. It's done. It's over. Your career is done. Now it's just a matter of, will you do that for 10 years to get to where you're doing $1 million a year, to where you can at that point rely on your weekly email to continue making $1 million a year and go build other businesses. Like, I've been kind of a part-time agent because I'm a full-time entrepreneur. Like, I'm building other businesses. And people can take that extra time and they can go spend more time with their family if they want to, or they can do what I do. They can go build other businesses and spend more time with their family. I'm kind of doing both.